Namaste bacho. Today let's start this class with a new chapter, chapter number 12, that is part 12, and the name of the chapter is Kanyakumari. So first let's do the summary of this chapter. You all must have heard about this place, Kanyakumari. It is the southernmost point of Indian peninsula, and it is the point where the three large water bodies, that is the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean, meet at a point. And here you can also see beautiful sunset and sunrise. So let's read this chapter. First we'll do the Kathin Shabd, that is difficult words. The first one is Kanyakumari. It is one of the famous districts of Tamil Nadu state. Next one is Dakshini. Dakshini means southern. Mahasagar means ocean. Suryoday means sunrise. Suryast means sunset. Bhagwati, it's a name of goddess. Next word is Smarak, means memorial. Vivekanand, that is Swami Vivekanand. He was one of the famous Indian monk. The last word is Visarjit. Visarjit means immersed. So let's read this chapter. First we'll do the Path Pravesh, that means lesson introduction. Here it's written, Kanyakumari Samudra Tat par basa ek Teerth Sthal hai. Samudra Tat means seashore. Teerth Sthal means pilgrim center. That means Kanyakumari is a pilgrim center which is located on the beach. Next line, Ye Bharat ke Dakshini Chor par sthit hai. Dakshini means southern. Chor means end. The meaning is, it is located at the southern end of India. Yahan Bhagwati ka mandir, Vivekanand Smarak, Mahatma Gandhi Smarak adi prasidh darshaniya sthal hai. Here Smarak means memorial, prasidh means famous, darshaniya sthal means place of interest. It means all these places are famous places of interest. Next line, log yahan bhakti bhav se dhyan karne aate hain. That means people come here to meditate with devotion. So let's start reading this chapter. Now you can see here, it's a conversation between Ram and Gopal. So here first Ram says, Gopal, garmi ki chuttiyon mein tum kahan gaye the? Here garmi ki chuttiyan means summer vacation. Here Ram is asking Gopal, where did you go during summer vacation? Gopal says, main Kanyakumari gaya tha. I went to Kanyakumari. Ram says, kya tum wahan akele gaye the? The meaning is, did you go there alone? Gopal says, nahi. Nahi means no. Mere mata pita, main aur meri behan Nidhi bhi gayi thi. That means, no, my parents, I and my sister Nidhi had also gone. So here sister's name is Nidhi. Next Ram says, Kanyakumari kaha hai? Where is Kanyakumari? Next Gopal says, Kanyakumari Bharat ke Dakshini chor par hai. That means Kanyakumari is at the southern end of India. Ise Kumhari Antarip bhi kehte hain. It is also known as Kumari Antarip. Pehle yah Keral Rajya ke adhin tha. Rajya means state, adhin means under. So the meaning is, earlier it was under the state of Kerala. Ab Tamil Nadu Rajya ke Dakshini Shore ka ek jila ban gaya hai. That means now it is one of the districts of the state of Tamil Nadu. Next Ram says, Kanyakumari ke bare mein aur bhi kuch batao. Meaning is, Ram is telling Gopal to tell something more about Kanyakumari. Next Gopal says, Kanyakumari ke dakshin mein Hind Mahasagar hai. Here dakshin means south, Hind Mahasagar means the Indian Ocean. So Gopal is saying that to the south of Kanyakumari lies the Indian Ocean. Paschim mein Arab Sagar aur purab mein Bengal ki khadi hai. Here Pashchim means west, Arab Sagar means the Arabian Sea, Purab means east, Bengal ki Khadi means Bay of Bengal. It means in the west is the Arabian Sea and to the east lies the Bay of Bengal. Tino dishao se lehre utkar kinare ki or aati hai. So here the waves rises from all the three directions and come towards the shore. Yahan ka suryoday aur suryast dekhte hi banta hai. So here suryoday means sunrise and suryast means sunset. The meaning of this line is that the sunrise and sunset is worth watching. Next line, Purnima ke din purab mein chandroday aur paschim mein suryast dono ek saath dekh sakte hain. So here it means on the full moon. Purnima means full moon. One can see the moon rise in the east and the sunset in the west. Now Ram says, yahan kaun kaun se mandir hai? Mandir means temple. So he is asking, what are the temples here? Gopal says, Dakshin Bharat apne mandiron ke liye prasiddh hai. The meaning is, South India is famous for its temple. Yahan sthit Kanyakumari Aman Mandir, Thanumalayan Mandir, Nagraj Mandir, adi pramukh mandir hai. Pramukh means main. So, all these three temples are the main temples located in Kanyakumari. Now, Ram says, Maine Kumari Bhagwati ke mandir ki charcha suni hai. I have heard about the temple of Kumari Bhagwati. Uske baare mein bata sakte ho. So, the meaning is, can you tell about this temple? Gopal says, ha ha, yes, yes. Kyon nahi? Why not? Next line, Samudra tat par bana Bhagwati Devi ka mandir ati prasiddh hai. The meaning is, the temple of Bhagwati Devi is very famous and it is built on the seashore. Yahan ki Devi gehno se alankrit hai. Gehno means ornaments, alankrit means adorned. The meaning is that here the goddesses is adorned with ornaments. Unki naak mein bahumulya heera jada hua nakful hai. Here naak means nose, bahumulya means precious, nakful means nose ring. The meaning is that her nose ring is studded with precious diamond. Next line, us heere ki kirne aankhon ko chakachaut kar deti hai. Chakachaut means dazzle. The meaning of this line is the rays from that diamond, it dazzle the eyes. Now Ram says, suna hai ki is devi ka darshan kar log apurv anand evam shanti paate hain. So here shanti means peace. So the meaning of this line is that Ram is saying, it is heard that people get immense joy and peace by visiting this goddesses, that is goddesses Bhagwati. So this much for today's class. The other half of this chapter we'll discuss in the next class. Now here you can see you have an activity. The activity is you have to read the first 10 lines of this chapter, record it and submit in Teams. That's all for today. We'll meet in the next class. Dhanyavaad.